e-commerce is not online only. If you want to be two generations ahead, you got to think OAO. So it's about the online and the offline experience. Nobody in Vietnam is thinking at that level yet. If you're just building website for customers, you're already behind.
Tom Ping, love what you're doing on your channel, buddy. Super congrats, you know, giving your time and energy to nonprofit business channel. Look, man, keep driving that audience. So Tom Ping, look forward to spending some time with you. I know you got the right mindset, so I'd love for you to share some of that from the big V. God bless, be great. 10X.
Chào thầy cô, chào anh chị. Em xin hỏi một câu hỏi là tại hồi nãy em có thấy trên slide có từ OAO là hình thức offline và hình thức online thì theo em được học trên trường học thì tụi em chỉ học tập trung vào hình thức online thôi, thì cái việc kết hợp giữa online và offline thì mình đẩy mạnh cái thế mạnh như thế nào, và như em là sinh viên thì sau này tụi em ra trường học về website này kia thì em có xu hướng sẽ học thêm về offline như là em thấy trên slide không?
I give you money.
Học cho tiền trước, cho tiền trước.
Okay, all right. Okay, I think that's a really important question. I want to answer that one. When we think about e-commerce, we think website. We think Lazada, we think Shopee. But actually, it's much, 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 much more than that. I just told you earlier that Lazada, Shopee is not spending a lot of energy on the website. They're spending their energy on how to build their logistics so they can deliver fast. So it's about the online and the offline experience. Let me give you two examples. One in the US, one from China. They're advanced implementations of e-commerce, but they're not about website. First, Amazon Go. In the United States, you can go to a store called Amazon Go. You walk in there, you just take whatever what you want, and then you leave. And then the police will not chase after you. The security guard will not chase after you. Because after you leave, there's cameras in the store. They recognize who you are. They know what you took or charged directly to your credit card. They do that by improving the customer experience. So customers go in the store, they take whatever they want. They don't have to line up. You go to Vinmar, you have to line up. Anybody here like to line up?
No.
Oh, that's right. That's why they removed that. Another example, it's called HEMA, or actually it stands for Hippo. It's a store in China, very big store, like Top Market here, or Mega Mart. And then you walk in there, you take out your phone, you just beep whatever you want. You just like scan whatever you want. And then you leave. And then whatever you scan will deliver to your house in 30 minutes. You don't even have to carry the product home. Why did they do that? Because they want to optimize the customer shopping experience. No lineup, and you don't have to carry anything home. So we don't have those things in Vietnam yet. But you know what? You can do those things with GoSell today already. Really, you can. Nobody in Vietnam is thinking at that level yet. But if you want to build a store like that, GoSell can do it already. So both examples I gave you, they have nothing to do with website. It's an integration between the online and the offline experience. You still go into the store, physical stores, but your order is processed in the cloud, by the internet, by some server. It's a hybrid between online and offline, right? It's like a human-machine hybrid, like RoboCon. Right, but that's the future. The future of e-commerce is not a website and an app. It's how you use online and offline integrated and give customer the best experience possible. And every major e-commerce company is thinking about this. So why we say OAO, OAO? Because e-commerce is not online only. If you want to be two generations ahead, you gotta think OAO. If you're just building website for customers, you're already behind. Is that a good answer? Okay, good. Thank you.